Hey Dorian, my name is Emilio, and in this video, we're going to be showing you the best and the most secure ways to transfer files on your Mac. Could be from one Mac to another, could be from one Mac to a PC, could be from a Mac to a phone. There's different ways to do it, and of course, you want to make sure that you're doing it securely so that those files remain protected and as safe as possible. Hey, as always, this video is brought to you by Moonlock, where we do cybersecurity software technology for humans. And remember, as always, to also click on that subscription button on the bell so you don't miss out on any of our video releases.
Now, one of the most traditional, safest ways to transfer files between devices, and this is from a Mac to a Mac, from a Mac to a phone, even between Windows and Mac devices, for example, would be what's called a FTP server. Now, FTP servers have been around a very, very long time. They're a little bit old school now, but now they've been replaced with what's called an SFTP server, which the S essentially stands for secure. And you can now actually transfer files from one device to another over an SSH shell. It's the most widely used secure way to transfer files over the internet and between devices. Now, the process is completely encrypted and completely secure and only allowing for authorized users. So you must have the specific username and password to be able to transfer files between one side to the other. The easiest thing to do is to go and download some SFTP software. Now, the one that I like to use is one here called FileZilla, available across multiple operating systems, including the Mac. Now, there are two things here. One is the SFTP server, and one is the SFTP client. So in my case, I've got a FileZilla server and a FileZilla client. If I go into the FileZilla server right over here, you need to go and download this and install it on a device. You've got point A, point B, whatever those two devices are. Let's say you're transferring from one Mac to another Mac. One of the Macs needs to be acting as the SFTP server, running the server software. The other side needs to go and be running the client, okay? Once the client is downloaded, which we can just do right over here, you'll notice that there are additional features here for paid versions, but we can just go ahead and download the free one. And this is the great thing, is that it is free. It's really, really easy to use right from here. This is going to be the IP address or the host name of the SFTP server. Remember, we're transferring from one to another. I am running here the client. The other side will be running the server. So you need to input the server's IP over here, throw in the username and the password, the port being the SFTP port 23 or 22, I should say, right over there, and then you establish the connection. Then what will happen is on the remote site, you'll see the files listed, and then you literally drag the files between one side to the other. FTP has been used for years. SFTP is the new version, running a secure, trusted, encrypted transfer method for files. Now, one method that is extremely easy to use and set up, and again, it is completely secure, is to use a service such as WeTransfer. What we want to do is we're going to go to WeTransfer.com over here. The easiest thing to do here is to input the email address of where the files are going, the email address of where you are, a title and a message, and then you just go ahead and upload some files. It's literally that easy. So I'm going to go ahead and put in my email address right here. My Mac video, here's how to reset your Mac. Go to your files. Select the video, which is 157 meg big, upload it, and it's now ready to go. Now, the nice thing about this is that it can be set to expire within a certain period of time. Again, completely safe, completely secure. It's only going to allow you to transfer to the person that you wanted to transfer, and then that link will then expire when it's no longer needed. Now, WeTransfer does allow you to have additional services if you, of course, go and pay, and there's lots of different pricing models available, especially if you're wanting to use it in a bigger scale, potentially in a business. Now, my favorite method, especially if you're using Apple devices between your Mac, between iPhones, iPads, etc., is to use AirDrop. Now, AirDrop is built in by default. All you need to do is you need to go into your Finder and actually look for the AirDrop section right over here. Now, what'll actually happen, I've got my phone, for example, this is my iPhone, it'll actually show up here in the list. So I'm gonna just go ahead and turn this one off. You'll see that no people are actually found. Now, in the bottom left-hand corner, you'll notice that AirDrop lets you share instantly with people nearby. Allow me to be discoverable by everyone, or by my contacts only, or by no one. The only thing with AirDrop is, because this is an Apple technology, if you're in a public space and somebody's trying to AirDrop things, right, or you're near another Apple device, and AirDrop is turned on and it's discoverable by everybody, then that may be seen. So you may want to actually go and adjust it so that it's contacts only. So I'm just gonna go ahead and unlock my phone, and then you'll notice that my iPhone has shown up in there. And then literally all I do is I go and grab and drag and drop some files. So here's an image, I'm gonna go and grab it and drag it into iPhone. Now what'll happen is that'll actually transfer it directly to my iPhone, and there is the photo right inside of my photos library. Now this is, as I said, completely encrypted, completely secure. Now the only thing about AirDrop is that you will need to be in the vicinity of the other device to be able to transfer those big files. But this is truly one of the best ways to transfer lots of data, even from a full Mac image to another Mac. It's brilliant.
So you have it. Let us know down below in the comments what you thought. If you did find this video helpful, would also love it if you follow our channel by clicking on that subscription button on the bell. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you on the next video.